At the Center for Leadership and Social Change, we are dedicated to transforming lives through leadership education, identity development, and community engagement. As a center that values leadership, diversity, and service, we encourage and support students to engage with the Tallahassee community. There are many spaces and places that hold lessons from the past in the city of Tallahassee. Lessons that should inform not only the way that we interact with community through service, but also that help us to understand more about who we are. In this video, we'd like to introduce you to one of those locations, Tallahassee's lost but incredibly important African American history, the historic district of Smokey Hollow.
Smokey Hollow is one of Tallahassee's forgotten neighborhoods, a community where people supported one another, and most importantly, it was a neighborhood filled with narratives of truth, progression, and talent in the face of heightened racial tensions in the South. Smokey Hollow was a predominantly Black, middle-class neighborhood filled with culture, community, and business between the 1890s to the 1960s. Smokey Hollow is located in their area that now houses Cascades Park and Appalachie Parkway, just blocks east of the Capitol Building. Smokey Hollow was home to many in the working and middle class. The Smokey Hollow community inhabited civil rights activists and leaders, musicians, and educators. One of the community's most notable members include Wally Amos, founder of Famous Amos Cookies, born and raised there until age 12. Smokey Hollow is also home to Nat and Cannonball Adderley, two famous jazz musicians who resided in Tallahassee during the 1940s. In such a tight-knit community, culture and music was plentiful. John G. Riley is one of Smokey Hollow's most notable community members. He was an educator, civil leader, and property owner in a Tallahassee community. Born enslaved and died a millionaire in 1954, John G. Riley's legacy lives on today. His legacy remains today as a legacy of the African-American middle class that emerged during his lifetime. In 1996, the historic Riley home became the George G. Riley Center and Museum of African-American History and Culture, preserving and recognizing unwritten African-American narratives, culture, and history. A unique aspect of Smokey Hollow's culture is its architecture. The community consisted of rows of shotgun-style homes truly significant to Smokey Hollow's history. Shotgun-style homes are single-story, narrow, and rectangular homes that were connected without hallways. Shotgun-style homes are prevalent in African-American communities in the South, representing a unique African-American contribution to American architecture. So what really happened to Smokey Hollow? How can a community so rich in culture, education, and community disappear? In the 1960s, everything changed. The state of Florida determined Smokey Hollow to be subject to urban renewal, which aimed to replace urban areas and real estate for more affluent commercial zones. The idea was to occupy the neighborhood for the expansion of downtown Tallahassee. The state exercised eminent domain and residents were told to leave. According to Dr. Jennifer Coslow at Florida State University, approximately 500 people lived in Smokey Hollow when the community began to become dismantled by the government. Federal programs such as urban renewal and eminent domain often set aside money for the community members to pay mortgages for their new homes. Many African Americans were either not given federal help or given a percentage of their home under its market value. This was not enough for many to be able to relocate, and so this displacement of a community left many Black families in poverty and experiencing homelessness. There was no available public housing created for the Smokey Hollow displaced residents. By the 1960s, the entire neighborhood was wiped out and members were displaced to neighboring communities where they were allowed and would be able to afford. However, it caused a scattering and thinning of community and connection between Black families. By 1978, only two houses remained, that of John G. Riley and John Hicks. For the last 40 years, after the displacement of Smokey Hollow residents, the space consisted of mostly parking lots and neglected empty space. It was not until 2009, 31 years later, when the city of Tallahassee and local government agencies started to work on the development of Cascades Park to be built in place of the neighborhood. In the construction and building of Cascades Park, community partners and members felt Cascades Park needed to commemorate the thriving community that had once sat in the same space. To preserve the memory of Smokey Hollow and the families that lived there, In 2014, the Smokey Hollow Village Open, which displays a group of three replicas of the shotgun homes. Alongside this village includes a walking trail from the site to the John G. Riley Museum and plaques of historical information. In 2018, an historic Smokey Hollow barbershop returned. The barbershop, integral to the Black community and culture, restored the community's spirit and heart. Although it is difficult to repair the damages done to the neighborhood, its impact has shaped, formed, and shared narratives near dear to the heart of the Tallahassee community. The Center for Leadership and Social Change acknowledges the truths of Tallahassee's history to shape student leadership, engagement, and service. Smokey Hollow's impact allows for students, community members, and educators to recognize this rich history. Rich history that allows for the community to bring back the memory of a neighborhood and appreciation and love so that it will never be forgotten again. We hope that you have learned a little more about this important part of the Tallahassee community and that you continue to seek out experiences to find out more.
Welcome to FSU and welcome to the Center for Leadership and Social Change, where we cherish community, amplify diverse voices, and transform lives through dialogue and service. Welcome and go Noles!